In Japan, you never have to pick up a gun again. You can start over and live a new life. Hi guys, my name is Siti Rukaya binti Ibrahim from SMKA Al-Irshad, and today I'm going to review one of the many mangas I've ever read called Banana Fish. Banana Fish is a Japanese manga series written and illustrated by Akimi Yoshida. It was serialized in the monthly manga magazine Besatsu Shoujo Comic from 1985 until 1994. This manga consists around 19 volumes in total. Banana Fish strikes to me as a very refreshing experience. First impressions are very important, and this manga series has accomplished that with the aesthetic story setting. It shows New York in a crime-driven state and conflicts dealing with mature contents, and that is just the tip of the iceberg. So what exactly is Banana Fish, ladies and gentlemen? The title itself is not necessarily about what Banana Fish really is. Rather, it's the pivotal component of the plot that has Ash, the main character of the manga, investigates into. The main premise focuses on how Ash's fight against the mafia in this rebellious stage. Crime lords like Dino Glazin is the stereotypical antagonist that you will quickly love to hate. Now, to be clear, I don't mean that in the sense of him being a distasteful human being. Rather, Ash has his own agenda to deal with him, considering their dark history together. This series is not shy to deliver mature context in the form of drug deals, criminal activities, sex slavery, or gang wars. So, if you're here for the manga, then be sure to suck it up and indulge in these controversial topics. In the meantime, we will also meet allies that Ash meets in his quest of vengeance. For instance, Eve, Max, and Jessica joining to fight the good fight. In many cases, their roles are all important for the overall missions. On the other hand, their most prominent adversary is Corsican Mafia, consisting Dino and his crew. Deep down, this manga crafts these antagonists with intentions to destroy Ash's life. This series then became a crime thriller that often tests the main character's limits and how much longer they can last. At its core, Banana Fish shows that in their society, crime is more than just a social problem. In our world, crime is not tolerable and punishable. In their society, however, the characters believe that they are above the law, and some even believe that they are the law. Let's take a look at Ash, for instance. Having been raised by Dino, it's clear that he has a dark past that has explored more and more as each chapter progresses. While I don't consider Ash to be a villain, there's no doubt that he has committed questionable acts. As this series takes place during a period of gang warfare, Ash stands out as more of an anti-hero than a protagonist to me. And of course, the man that raised him wants nothing more than just to destroy his life. In many cases, I think Dino wants to destroy Ash's soul more than just destroying his life. It's a fate perhaps even worse than death, and just one of the many examples of how cruel characters can really be. Indeed, Banana Fish contains mature content and is not suitable for a younger audience. For your information, this manga has also been adapted into an animation. It is Akimi Yoshida's most well-known work, and MAPPA has managed to produce such series with commitment. It celebrates the chance to showcase a crime story in a setting of corruption, revenge, and politics. And now it's your chance to experience that story. That's all from me. Thank you.
Sayonara.